Hello and welcome to this Marble Maze workshop. In this workshop, I will demonstrate how you can create your own marble maze with your circular knitting machine. A marble maze is good for feel and fidgeting. It will strengthen fingers, brain and muscles. I also created a marble run triddle muff. This marble run triddle muff is also stuffed with marbles and you can push them around. And it's also a muff that will warm people's hands. So, in the description below, you will find a link to that workshop. So, the marble maze is knitted with a circular knitting machine with 20 or 22 needles. You can use whatever small knitting machine. Of course, we need yarn. And we need our yarn needle, and we use marbles or beads or a rattle, or you can make your own beads, marbles. You can use whatever you like, no rules. So let's start. We start with knitting tubes. We cast on with scrap yarn. We make sure we start at our first needle and we do our zigzag cast on all the way around, and as you know, the last needle never has a loop. Cut your yarn. See, the last needle does not have a loop. Then we put another piece of scrap yarn into our feeder between the last and the first needle. I marked the bump where we put the yarn, so you will always recognize the part between the last and the first needle. And we are going to knit one round with our scrap yarn. Make sure you also knit the last needle so that it grabs the yarn. You cut your scrap yarn and put it in the middle between the last and the first stitch where the marked bump is. So there are a lot of pieces that now there. And then you take your working yarn and you put that into the feeder. Make sure there is a long tail that fits around your machine because you need it for closing the tube. Make sure you put the end between the last and the first needle where the marked bump is, and then you are going to knit. For my marble maze, I knitted tubes with 50 rounds, so but you can knit them as long as you like. So I'm knitting 50 rounds. I'm done knitting and I am going to cut my yarn. I put it one time around my machine and cut it. Then I take it out of my feeder and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle where the marked bump is. So at that place we put it to the inside. Then I take another piece of scrap yarn, I put it into my feeder and between the first and the last needle where the marked bump is, and I'm going to knit one round with scrap yarn. Make sure you knit the last needle and then you cut your yarn and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle where the marked bump is, and then you grab another piece of yarn that's long enough to fit around your machine, cut that and put that into your yarn needle. To release the yarn that's under the needles, we have to crank further without knitting. So no yarn into the feeder and you crank further until your marked bump stands on clockwise 1/4 to 10. You take your yarn needle and we have to look close. You are going to pick up the first stitch that's knitted with your scrap yarn. So that's this stitch. Pick it onto your scrap yarn. Make sure you don't pull it all the way through. I like to pull my work from under my machine and then I can easily pick up the rest of the stitches. So I'm going to cast off all the way around. I'm making sure that my stitches all are knitted correct. And I'm picking up my stitches, cranking slowly further till I released everything from the machine. And there's my tube. I'm going to arrange it neat. Make sure that all the pieces of yarn are on the outside. And I'm knitting more tubes till I am done. The next step is to close one half of our tube. We are going to close the top. We have our saved working yarn into our yarn needle and we are going to take a look at our scrap yarn. We have a beginning and an end point with our scrap yarn, and the last stitch with scrap yarn is the stitch where your working yarn is connected to. The next stitch is the first stitch. We are going to stick our needle into the first stitch from the outside to the inside of your tube and then to the last stitch where your working yarn is connected to. You take your working yarn and you put it with a half knot around your loop and then you pull your loop, your needle through the loops and your yarn is secured so it will not move anymore. And now you are going to pick up pairs of stitches in your working yarn collar. And when you have a pair, you put your yarn around the needle and pull through. You can pull real tight. You have to learn everything about feeling the tension, but you are going to make sure that all the pairs are connected with your yarn and a little loop around your needle. So put your needle through the two loops that makes one pair, put your yarn around the needle, pull through, and continue doing this all the way till the last pair. You should have 11 pairs, but you don't have to count. Make sure you do not stick through the yarn. I always do that when it's not needed. And when you do it, it's not a real problem, but then you have to cut loose your yarn at the end, your scrap yarn. So I'm at the last stitch. I do exactly the same as I did the 10 times before. And I leave my tail loose so I can adjust the tension a little bit. Then I'm going to rip out the scrap yarn. You see that when you do not stick through the yarn, you can pull it out easy. And we are going to close the ends of all our tubes, but only one end. See, it's nice and closed. And it's an easy closing. So you're going to close the ends of all your tubes. You can adjust tension by just pulling the yarn a little bit. You can do that later. So let's continue and do this with all our tubes. One side. I finished those four ends. And now I'm going to connect two tubes. I take a piece of yarn that's longer than my tubes. And I take those two tubes together with the closed ends at the beginning. And we try to find the last two stitches our yarn. We poked our yarn through, and that's the track we are going to follow. You see, those tracks are one straight line, and that's the track we are going to follow. On the first piece, we stick our needle between those two half stitches under one bar, and then we find our corner stitch also at the second one and stick our needle under the one bar that should be the corner bar. Pull your yarn not all the way through, leave a piece hanging, and then we are going to stick in where we came out under two bars and pull the yarn through. And then we go to the opposite side where we came out and we put our needle under two bars and pull through. And that we continue all the way till the end. Stick in where it came out on the two bars and stick in the needle on the opposite side, the same place it came out on the two bars, and make sure you keep the right track and continue all the way till the end. Take your time to do this. You can do this very loose because we are going to pull the yarn when we are finished. It's going to be a seamless join. See, when you pull the yarn, you can just close it and it's seamless. That's so nice. So, continue till the end. I'm almost at the end and I keep continuing what I am doing. And maybe one tube is longer than another one. You just cheat and you pick up three bars or one bar to make them even. Nobody will notice. So I'm going to pull my yarn and you will see the magic happen. And they're connected and seamless. You continue connecting the next tubes. Let all the tails hang because we need them at the end. So ignore them. I'm almost done with this. Last few stitches for my last tubes connecting. I'm doing the magic trick again. I really love it. It's very soothing to see it happening. And then we continue with the next part. We are going to close the opposite ends, but before we do that, we have to put our marbles or beads in the tubes. Don't forget that. And then you are going to do exactly the same as on the opposite side. You find your first and last stitch. This is my last stitch, so left is my first stitch and I'm going to connect them. Exact the same way we did on the opposite side. And I'm going to do this tube by tube. And leave the tails hanging. We will fix the ends at the end. I'm almost finished with my first tube. And then I can pull out my working of my scrap yarn. When I did not poke through them, but I probably did. So I have to cut it open. Where's my scissors? Look, see, I poked through, so that's why I always say be careful. And there it is. Leave that tail hanging and continue with the rest. Put in a marble and start closing the next color. And do that for all tubes. Don't forget to put the marbles in. And I see you back when you have closed everything like I did. Now, we have all those ends. And this piece of yarn, scrap yarn, see, it's split. I did that. And when you try to pull it out, it will make a mess. I will demonstrate that so you can see what's happening. Also on the other side. So I just cut it. And ta-da! Solved. Now we have to connect those ends that they are going to be neat, and I just do that by making knots, knot them firm and stick the ends between both layers. And then we have to make the maze. I'm finished with putting away all my ends, and I stick needles into the tubes to define my mazes. I make three different mazes and I mark that sewing lines with my needles. So I'm just going to sew this straight line, and here I'm going to Therefore, I'm going to make a little loop in my working yarn. I stick my needle at the beginning of my line through both layers. Make sure that it's in the right track. And then I put my little loop at the end of my yarn around my needle and pull it closed. And then I pull my yarn through that loop so my yarn is connected. That end I will stick between the layers at the end. And now I'm going to just make a line. For my maze. I'm just make sure that they're in the same track.
I'm struggling a bit, but a few stitches further, it will go very smooth. When you have the track, you keep on track. And you can make all kind of mazes. You can look up sewing maze ideas, and you can see different mazes. But I will show you the mazes I made when I'm finished with doing this. This is my finished maze. I can crochet a border around it if I want to, but for now it's okay. Every color has its own maze. So, if you like my workshop, give me a thumb up, join my channel, check my playlists for all kind of fidgets, to knit and to crochet. All the fidgets I made with my circular knitting machine. I also have all kind of circular knitting machine free workshops, from dolls to blankets. Watch my playlists, join my channel, and continue with crafting as long as you can, because it's very healthy to do. Thank you for watching. Ching, have a nice day, with a lot of love from Holland, and bye bye.